This morning, we want to turn your attention to the book of Luke. Amen. Luke, the 15th chapter. Luke, the 15th chapter. Amen. And we're going to be reading verses 12 through 24. Luke, the 15th chapter. And we're going to read verses 12 through 24. Luke chapter 15 and verses 12 through 24. And when you have it, say amen. Amen. If you don't have it, say hang on. Ask everyone would rise in reverence to the reading of the Holy Word. Amen. Amen. And this is the word of the Lord. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. And he would have fain have filled his belly with the husks that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. And when he came to himself, he said, How many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said to his servants, Bring forth the best robe, and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and shoes on his feet. And bring hither the fatted calf, and kill it, and let us eat, and be merry. For this my son was dead, and is alive again. He was lost, and is found. And they began to be merry. Amen. Amen. We're going to focus on the part that says, He was lost and is found. And they began to be merry. Amen. And that's what our topic is going to be about today. The lost and found. The lost and found. Normally when we hear this term, the first thing that comes to mind is a place where things that are lost are brought so people can claim them. Or we think about a department or a service or a location where items that are found can be claimed by their owners. But if you ever notice, they always have that box sitting in a special place. And it's not hidden, but it's right out in front where everybody can see it. But the thing is, the way it works, when you have a lost and found box, you have people that hadn't lost anything and don't need to find anything, but they're always searching to see what they can claim from that box. They search to claim for things that are not their own, but they seek it to make it their own. But as we look at our context today, the lost and found pertains less to personal items and more to spiritual interests. Lost in this context means to destroy fully. It means to perish. It means to die. You notice that word loss, in the biblical context, say it again, it means to destroy fully. Not to destroy, but to destroy fully. It means basically to eliminate it, to have no further existence, no further mention of it. It means to perish. It means to die. And remember what Jesus said when he came. He said, his Father sent him into the world, his only begotten Son, so that man would not, what? Perish. Found in this context means this. It means simply to find. It means to get. It means to obtain. It means to perceive. But it also means to see. Now, we understand this. Lost points to those who reject salvation through Jesus Christ, but found points to those who receive salvation through Jesus Christ. Lost is associated with the unbeliever who has reservations along with Lucifer in hell, while found is associated with the believer who has reservations with the Lord in heaven. That's what the brother was talking about this morning. The deacon talked about this morning. He said the voice came and told him, I go and prepare a place that where I am, you may be also. Lost is anyone who participates in and who embraces the ways of the world. Found is anyone who participates in and embraces the will of the word. Understand? Those who seek after the world and they say they're looking to find themselves, they're actually lost. Anyone who leaves and goes all over the world saying, I'm trying to find myself, and does it in the world, they're lost when they start from the beginning. And there's no way they're going to find themselves out in the world. But understand this, as we said, found is anyone who participates in and embraces the will of the word. Whenever you decide to follow the word, whenever you decide to embrace what the word says and what the word teaches, then you are found. Now, sadly, many people today seem to have been lured and linked to the lost instead of being fascinated and fixed in the found. It raises two questions in particular. The first question is this. Why are people attracted to the lost and avoiding the found? The second question is this. It says, why are many people drawn by the lost world's gossip and tabloids and detested by the living word's gospel and the truth? You ever notice? Everybody in the world is drawn to lies. They're drawn to drama. Everybody wants to try to see what's going on with the Kardashians or find out what's going on in some artist's life. Everybody's looking at what's going on with, who is it? The rapper that she's having a child for, the baby daddy, Kanye West. They're more worried about Kanye West than they worry about the word of God. They worry more about what the soccer players and the athletes are doing rather than what they ought to be doing in God's house. They're worried about what's going on in the world. I noticed this, and what Sister Young was talking about this morning about a watchful eye. It gets you perturbed when you hear about drama shows on TLC that's talking about the preacher's daughters. And the daughters are doing everything according to the world, but they aren't living by the word. Now they say they have a new show coming out, The Preachers Themselves. Now, why would preachers come on television and produce a dramatic lifestyle and make the world think that the way that they live is a worldly life rather than a life that is living according to the word? It doesn't make sense. They're lost when they do these type of things. Now understand this. The Holy Word provides an answer to the questions that we asked this morning. When we look in 2 Corinthians 4:4, this is what it says. It says, if the good news we preach is hidden behind a veil, it is hidden only from people who are perishing. Notice it says this. He says, Satan, who is the god of this world, has blinded the minds of those who don't believe. They are unable to see the glorious light of the good news, and they don't understand this message about the glory of Christ, who is the exact likeness of God. The reason why they can't accept the gospel and they go after the gossip is because that's what the devil is putting before them. That's what he's using to attract them. That's what he's using to draw them. So when you come with the truth, is that the actor said they can't handle the truth because they aren't ready to receive what God has given in the light of Jesus Christ. The parable of the prodigal son. We oftentimes see it as a story about a son leaving home going out into the world and coming back, but it's actually a portrait of the realm of the lost and the realm of the found. You notice what the Father said, and I've heard this story all my life. I've seen it preached and I've heard it preached, but we always forget to look at the part where the Father says this statement. He once was lost, but now he's found. And some will say, well, how could you say he was lost? He only went into another country. Let's deal with that right now. If you notice, it reveals what a person experiences when they are lured into the realm of the lost versus what they experience when they are fixed in the realm of the found. Something could be lost and it could be in the same room with you. We've done it before. We say, I lost my keys. And they're in the same house where you've been living all the years of your life. But yet you'll search for it. And when you search, you say, oh, I found my keys. So how can you say someone can be lost and found at the same time? God is showing us you can be lost and still be in the house. You can be found, thank you, Holy Ghost, and still be in the house. Understand, there are many people that go to the church house and claim to be Christians and say that they are saved, but they're lost. How can you tell they're lost? Because the life that they lead reflects the life of someone who's lost, not someone who's found. Let's look into the word. When a person is in the realm of the lost, they become arrogant, they become disrespectful, and they display selfishness. Notice what he said the son did. The son went to the father. He's in his house. He has everything that he needs, and it says he just goes to the father. He doesn't ask him. It says he went to his father and said, I want my inheritance. He didn't say, Father, could you see fit to give me what is due to me? He didn't even ask his father. He just went to him and said, give me what's mine. That's what he said. Give me what's mine. And so the minute you take that attitude, you're leading down the path of the lost. Then it says, you can tell they're in the realm of the lost because they start out having all that they have gained and all that they have inherited. And look what they do with it. They gather it together. In other words, it's all in hand and it's all on hand. You ever notice? And I always remember this when they show the kids getting ready to run away or somebody getting ready to leave. They always show them gathering what they have and putting it in their little container and going in with their luggage and walking down the street. And I'm leaving. I'm running away. I'm going out into the world where I can do what I want to do, live the way I want to live. I'm tired of being under the rule. I don't like these rules in the house. But then they always come back. The old folk would tell you this, well, where you think you're going? I'm taking everything that's mine and I'm leaving. Well, none of that you're taking belongs to you. But what do you mean? These are my pants. No, those are the pants that I bought you. Well, this is my shirt. No, that's the shirt that I bought you. Well, this is my suitcase. No, matter of fact, that's my suitcase. Where you think you're going with it? Everything that you have on, even your underwear, belongs to me. So how are you going to say, I'm taking what's mine and I'm leaving? The minute you leave and step out from the found place, you go into the lost place. Because what happens? The minute you step out of found, everything that you had, you lose it. Everything that you gain, you lose it. Everything that you thought was yours, you lose it. Then it says this. Those who are in the realm of the lost, notice, they wind up in a far country. You notice the Bible didn't say where he was. It just said he wound up in a far country. Far in this context means this. It means a distant, empty expanse. God is wonderful, ain't it? Now notice, the devil said, get everything that you got. Everything that you own, pack it up and come on and bring it on over to where I am. So you're taking everything that you have and bring it into a place that has nothing. You notice that's how the world does? It takes somebody that has a gift and it brings them into a place where they don't have anything. And what happens once it gets into the world? Everything that they had, what happens? It tells us in the next scripture, their fortunes are wasted in reckless and loose from restraint living. What did it say? The son had everything. Everything that his father had put aside for him, the father gave it to him. He took it out into a world that had nothing. But when he got to the world took everything that he had. You notice? When you go into a lost place, you lose everything that you have. Then it says this. They and everything they have winds up spent. Spent is another word for this. It's gone. When you spent, what happens? You're tired. You just can't go on. You're fatigued. You're down to a point where you just can't go no more. And notice the Bible said everything that he had became spent. I mean, it was used up. It was useless. It was no good. It wasn't worth anything anymore. Now notice when it was at his daddy's house, it was worth a lot. But once he got into the world, it wasn't worth anything. It lost its worth. There's this. When you're in the realm of the lost, they become the victim of not just famine, but mighty famine. Famine is a state of leanness. It's a state of recession. It's a state where everything is drawn away and so slowly taken out of you. You're drained of everything that you have. Notice, and it's not just a little bit, it's mighty. When the world takes it, it doesn't just take a little bit, it takes it all. I always remember it was a scene on Martin where they had the show. And his friend had this lady that he was dating, and she supposedly was a big lady. And so they told him what he needed to do. Said, go back and tell her it's going to be your way or no way at all. And so he took the advice of his friends, and he went to her. And he said, when he went and he told her, this the way it's going to be or ain't going to be at all. He said, all of a sudden, she did a move on me. She went up and she came down. And when she went up, she came down on my whole right side. When it was a come down, it was a mighty come down. You ever notice? When something happens in the world, it don't come down on you easy. It's like the old people say, we're going to come down on you hard. Now notice this, it also says this, when you're in the world of the lost, they become connected with the carnal, connected with the crooked, connected with those who have a corrupt character. You notice, all before, everything was fine, everything was dandy. As long as they had the money, they had friends. As long as they had possessions, they could party. But as soon as everything started leaving, what happens? All of those that were running with you, all of those who were befriending you, all of those that were embracing you, now all of a sudden, the only ones you see are the sharks and the snakes and the serpent, because they come now, they see you in need, and so now they say, well, look, I can help you out. If you want to get out of this state, just come along with me. I got this scheme we can run. I got this job we can pull. I got this store we can hit. I know this house we can go. All of these things, all of a sudden, they get dealt with things where, what is it? A downward spiral. Then it says this, when you're in the realm of the lost, those who are in that realm become slaves to sacrilege. They fall to a level of being willing to feed on filth. You notice, they're not worried about eating steak dinners no more. They're not worried about eating filet mignon and the best catfish and oysters. Now they just happy to get what they can get. If they can't find catfish, they'll go into the trash can and eat what they can eat there. If they can't find a steak, they're happy just to find a left piece of a hamburger that somebody just happened to throw on the ground. All of those wonderful things that they saw, even the slightest thing become beautiful now. It becomes the best meal in the world. That's what happens when you're in the land of the lost. But notice when a person is in the realm of the found, notice what the Bible says. They recognize where their help comes from and whom their blessing lies. You know what the young man said? He said, he came to himself. In other words, he found himself. And when he found himself, he said, I need to go back home, my father's house. My father was supplying everything that I needed. I didn't have no want when I was at my father's house. Even my servants would supply my needs at my father's house. That's where my blessings were. My father would bless me with food, bless me with clothing, bless me with everything that I needed. When you're in the realm of the realm, you understand? Help us, Holy Ghost. You get up and go to your father. You notice? You don't stay at home. You get up and go to your daddy's house. You get up and worship with your daddy. You get up and go see what your daddy do. You get up and go have a conversation with your father. When you're in the realm of the found, you communicate with him and you confess to your daddy. You notice what the son did? Once he was found, he said, I'm going to go to my daddy. And I'm going to humble myself. And I'm going to confess everything that I, Father, Daddy, I wronged you and heaven. I'm not worthy to be called your son. I was wrong. I'm not worthy to be elevated to where I was before. If you just bring me back at a low state, just let me come back into your house, everything will be fine. Then you notice it says this. Those who are in the found realm, they humble themselves before their father. What did the young man say? He said, I'll run to my father, bow down to him, and say, Father, I'm sorry. When you're in the realm of the found, it says they are seen, they are received, they are embraced, and they are kissed by their father. Notice this. He says the young man went home before he can get to the house. The Bible says his father saw him. Now notice this. And the father saw him, he ran to his son. And after he ran to his son, before his son could tell him what he had done wrong, he said, I already know. That what the Bible tells us before we pray to our father, he said, before you ask me, I already know what you're going to ask for. And why are you talking to me? I've already answered your prayer. And so while the son was talking to the daddy, the father said, don't worry, I know. I know everything that's going on. And he said he took him and he embraced him and pulled him into his arms. Not only did he do that, but he kissed him. Y'all know how it is. Young men don't like their daddy to kiss them. Don't kiss me. I'm grown now. But he grabbed his son and he kissed him because he showed him that he loved his son. After that, it says this. Those who are in the realm of the found, they are clothed and celebrated by their father. You notice what happened? He said, don't need to even talk about it. He called to his servants, get the fatted calf. Take those clothes off of him. Take those lost clothes off of him. Put the robe on him. You notice a robe is a robe of royalty. Put the robe on him. Then he said, put a ring on his finger. The ring signified authority and heirship. Put a ring on, put some sandals on his feet. Cover up them feet. Those are feet of the found. Those feet should be taken care of because the way he was walking in the past was walking wrong, but he's walking right now. Put them sacred sandals on his feet. Then it says this, those who are in the realm of the found. I like this part, say they are favored and fed by the Father. Look what it said. Go get the servants. Go get the rest of the family. Call together everybody. We're going to have a feast. My son that was lost, he found. We're going to celebrate and be happy because he came to himself. But notice this. When you're in the realm of the found, you share the joy of the Father. How do you know you share the joy of the Father? In every situation, when Jesus was born, the Father celebrated. What they say? Joy to the world. Peace on earth. Goodwill toward men. When Jesus went down and got ready to be baptized and he came up out of the water, what did the Bible say? The Father said, this is my beloved son
in whom I'm well pleased. When the disciples saw him on the Mount of Transfiguration and they saw the glory of Jesus and they saw Moses and Elijah, what did the Father say? This is my beloved Son. Hear him. You notice? The joy of the Father. The joy of the Father is always expressed in the realm of the found. It's a wonderful thing. Fathers love to brag on their sons. Parents love to brag on their children. When they see their child doing something that's wonderful, what is it? That's my boy. That's my son. Who is that running on the football field? That's my boy. Who just made the winning shot? That's my boy. Who that walking across the stage getting this degree? That's my boy. The joy of the Father. So as we leave you today, don't be pulled into the punishment or the life of the lost. Remain positioned in the provision of the life of the found. Have a word for you. Don't be frustrated. Don't become faint just because the devil has painted an illusion that living lost is living large. You ever notice that? The ones who are in the lost world are always talking about how large they're living. I'm living a platinum lifestyle. I'm living a gold lifestyle. I'm living it up. I'm living large, but they lost. Bible says this, realize what the prodigal son came to recognize. Always remember this. Hear this, children. The found function in the favor of the Father. Hear that? The found function in the favor of the Father. Our advice today, the word today says, function in the favor. Function in the favor means this. God says, God has made this light shine in your hearts so you could know the glory of God that is seen in the face of Jesus Christ. Function in the favor. Function in the favor that says, we're pressed on every side by troubles, but we're not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We're knocked down, but we're not destroyed. Huh? You may knock you down, but you're gonna get back up. You may trip, but you won't fall. And even if you fall, you're gonna get back up again. What did the songwriter say? We fall down, but we get up. What did Jesus say? Tear down this temple, and in 3 days, I'm gonna raise it again. That's what happens when you function in the favor. Function in the favor that says, we never give up. Though our bodies are dying, our spirits are being renewed every day. Look what God does. You may go to bed tired, but when you get up with power. I always remember, you ever notice God set it up this way? You ever see a fighter when he gets knocked down? Or you see a player when they get knocked down? You ever notice how they get up? Whenever they get up, it doesn't matter what the situation is. If you're a football player, a basketball player, a boxer, MMA, it doesn't matter. When they get knocked down, the first thing they do before they get up, they always on the knee. And from the knee, they get up. And the devil don't have enough sense to figure it out. The last thing you want to do is knock a child down. Because when you knock him down, that means he's going to get on his knees. And when he get on off his knees, he's going to get up with power. Function in the favor. Function in the favor that says, we don't look at the troubles. Hear me, children? We don't look at the troubles. We can see now. We fix our gaze on the things that cannot be seen. In other words, it might look bad. What did Minister Mo say? It's bad out there. It's bad out there. But before he would go on, he said, but before I say anything else, let me go on another further. You see, you ought to be able to see beyond the bad and see the blessing. See beyond the dead and see the divine. See beyond all of the losses and see what God has prepared for you in your living. Function in the favor. But when you function in the favor, it says, the things we see now will soon be gone. But the things that we cannot see will last forever. Say, well, how do you know heaven is there? Because it's in my heart. How do you know God is in glory? Because he put it in my heart. How do you know you have a house in glory? Because the word tells me, Jesus told me, God revealed it, and the Holy Ghost reminds me. Function in the favor. Function in the favor that says, amazing grace, how sweet the sound, that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Blind, but now I see. Function in the favor. Function in the favor. Because God has given you everything that you need. Everything that you need to survive. Everything that you need to triumph. Everything you need to win. Function in the favor. That's the word. The found. Function in the favor. Because God says, don't worry about it. You once were lost, but guess what? When you called out, I found you. And because I found you, everything is all right now. Because I found you, everything is all right. I'm holding you in my hand. And as long as I'm holding you in my hands, can nobody or nothing pluck anything or anybody out of my hands. Because God says this. Let's celebrate. Let's be joyful. Let's be merry. Because what was lost and who was lost, now they're found. So if anybody asks you, what are you? I'm found. Who are you? I'm found. Because you're found, what does that mean? I function in the favor. Because I'm found, I'm my Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Because I'm found, I'm my Father's. And that's all I need to know. And because I'm my Father's, he's already told me, you my son, you my daughter, you my child. And can nothing in this world take that away from you? Because Paul said, can nothing separate us from the love of God that we have through Christ Jesus? Children, function in the favor of the found, because that's where God has put us. That's where God has placed us. Amen. Amen.